Hey, this is Kevin from LetMeTechYou, and in this video, we're going to be going over Terraform modules and how they can kind of help, self-contain your code to make it a lot easier to not. Also, I guess you could say read, configure. There's a lot of things that you can do to reduce code redundancy by using modules that were built either by yourself or someone on your team, someone from the provider that you're going to be using. So, with that being said, modules, if you haven't looked into this before, are just a collection of files that you already kind of have already been doing. So modules in a sense just are built in a way to allow you to repeatedly build infrastructure without having to write the same code over and over again. And with modules, everything that you write in or build, if I can pull up a folder, add a folder to the workspace here. So if I look at, let's say, something I've already done. So if I add this in here, so everything inside this folder is essentially called the root module. And with this, when you call this, you're essentially calling the root module to deploy everything that's inside of it. And that's essentially what modules are doing whenever you're calling ones that are from providers such as Azure or AWS. You're calling files within the folder to deploy the infrastructure that you need. And we won't get into actually building modules, because it's a little more in depth, not necessarily because of the syntax and what's needed, but because of the best practices that should be in place when you're building modules to make sure that they're easily reusable and you make them in a way that other people could use them if you're, within a team environment. So I'm going to pull up the portal here, Terraform's website, and show you where the modules are located. So when you come to their website, you have providers and then you have modules. The provider is what we've been using, to where you can choose, the cloud provider that you're building some stuff for. And then you have what's called the modules here, which up here. So for, let's say you're configuring some information or networks on Azure, and you want a simple way to deploy a virtual network. Well, you can do that by coming in here, and let's say we choose Azure. And as you can see, these are some of the different modules that they support. So you got one that's for naming, a VNet one, a network one. So I'm going to click on the one that says network. And then from the top here, just going down, you can see that this module uses a provider from an official HashiCorp partner. You have the version up here. You have how many downloads this week, downloads this month, this year, and an overall time. So that's just a nice little statistic to see that it's actually being used a lot. So if you saw that like being real low, maybe there's not a lot of development behind it, or it's not actively being developed by the provider. So that's something to kind of look into, especially if you're looking to have something actively added to it over time. And then you can see who the module is managed by, and then also the source code. So if we open this up here in another tab, we'll see all the source code and the README information that also is shown on the page that we're on here. Which, as you can see here, you got the README information. So just some stuff about the different versions, the usage around it. And then inputs. So you have required inputs, and then you have optional outputs or inputs. The required ones are ones that you need. So as you can see, you need a resource group name and then the use for each here. So they might have that shown. Yeah, so here they have, use for each equals true, tags, environment, devs, senders, call center, IT. So as you can see there, the thing, so you always need the source, where it's coming from. Then we got the resource group name. And the resource group name, it looks like it's being built from up here. And then the address space, the subnet prefixes, the subnet names. So what we could actually do is we could actually take this exactly how it is and use this to build it out. So as you can see up here, to provision the infrastructure, this is all you really need right here. So I can copy this and just gonna paste this down here. And then we're gonna put in our required inputs, which is resource group name. And then it gives you the type. So you can see type is string and use for each is Boolean, which is, you know, true or false. So we're gonna set this to Kevin RG, or module RG. And then actually let's go, let's see where, what else we wanna add? Oh yeah, we need the use for each. So use for each, we're gonna set this to false. And let's see what happens. So this is all we're gonna set here. Now, I don't know, it actually might not even take, we might actually have to create a resource group. Let's see what happens here. What error message we get. So Terraform init. So as you can see, it's downloading the provider plugin and everything. We got our modules that were downloaded, our network. And then as you can see, you can actually go in and look at everything that's being written to deploy this virtual network. Now, I would also recommend to also always do this because it kind of helps you understand how these are being built, possibly even allow you to come in and not necessarily make edits to this, but build your own modules for specific things. Now, I wouldn't recommend just building modules just because sometimes you could be building modules when it's not really needed. So it's really kind of to try to, you know, build out ways to reduce code duplication amongst your team or yourself, not necessarily just to build modules, just to build them. So as you can see here, you got the resource, the Azure on virtual network, the address space, length, var.address spaces. So you see they have variables in here. You got your default stuff if you're not listing anything. So basically, this is going to build stuff by default if you don't provide any of the information yourself. So we're going to go back here and let's do a Terraform plan. Source code. Insufficient features. Oh, let me go back here. So we need to add, I always forget what it is. Let's go here. Yeah, right there. So let's put this there. And so this is going to give me a plan. I'm assuming this, if this might, I wonder if it's going to ask me to build, you know, no resource group, if this needs to be built ahead of time, but we'll see here. Yeah, so it's saying resource group not found. So actually what we're gonna need to do is come in and actually do what they did on the example on the README. Take this, copy that. So this just builds a resource group. We're gonna put this in Central US. Call it main. And then for the resource group, we're going to call it AzureRM.name. And then for the name, we're going to call this Kevin Module RG. And we're going to save that. Now let's do another Terraform plan. And And this should give us some output here, unless we get another error in regards to the use for each. So it's looking to see, is the Kevin module RG was not found. So let's do this. So what we're going to need to do, so it looks like you're going to have that built first. So let's do a Terraform plan on this. And this should give me the option for one resource group to be built. So we're going to say Terraform apply auto approve. Then I'm going to come back in here, put that back in. You can actually take this out if we want. And then, so what you could do now, if you wanted to deploy this in a resource group that's already deployed, you could, instead of doing the resource block, you can do a data, a data Azure RM underscore resource. So, you know, you do a data block to then pull that in and use it within your resource group name here. So now that that's actually deployed, we're going to save this and we're going to do another Terraform plan. So now this should, now that it should be able to see our, so this is just saying an argument is deprecated with module on line 33. It's saying enforce link. Okay, so this is something within the module that's deprecated. So that's fine. It will be removed in favor of the private endpoint network policies in version 4 of the Azure RM provider. So that's just a way to kind of go in and make that edit or even put in a change control in GitHub to have that updated. So now what we could do is a Terraform apply auto approve. And of course, now we only use the defaults, but what you would want to go through and actually do is use all your different inputs. So you want to make sure you're defining your address space, address spaces, DNS servers, resource group location, subnet delegation, you know, whether you want to delegate it to, you know, Microsoft server farms or something, private link, subnet names, prefixes, all this stuff you want to, you know, do. You don't want to just do the required stuff unless you're just testing around like how we are here. Now, if we go into the portal, I think I should have that up. Pour this over here. So if I pull this over here, we should see that under resource groups, my Kevin module RG is built, and then my ACCT VNet is built, along with all my subnets here, 10.0.1.0. And that's basically it. So that's kind of the gist of modules. As you can see, we didn't have to build out a bunch of code. We didn't have to do all of the things that you would see inside this network module. So all of this Azure RM virtual network, subnets, all of this is already built out for you. The only thing you had to do was define the input variables. And then there's also some options for outputs and stuff like that. And then to delete, it's just a matter of Terraform destroy. And then I'm just going to do an auto approve, which you wouldn't want to do in a production network because then that would destroy everything. You do want to do the Terraform destroy to then approve it if you are in favor of getting rid of everything that you see in there. So that's it there for modules. If you have any questions in regards to using them or any of the other information that you would have in regards to setting them up, reach out to me down below. I'll be sure to get back with you. Again, check out my site, letmetechyou.com. Again, thanks for tuning in. Hope to see you next time.